If you are new to Mikrotik devices, then you might not be aware of all the possibilities offered by the operating system of our routers. Starting with how you connect and manage your router, the options are plentiful, as you're about to find out. Typical home routers that you might have used in the past come with a web user interface that you access by entering the router's LAN address into the browser. All routers devices offer this as well. If you purchased a wireless access point for a home or a small office, and you just want to make some minor changes and move on, then this might be the method for you, as it will be very quick and simple. You just connect to the wireless or one of the LAN ports. Make sure you're not trying to use the WAN port or the console port, if you have one. And then you do the usual thing with the router's IP address in the browser. Use the default login credentials. If there is a password, it will be on the label of your device. Otherwise, just leave the password field empty. The most common settings can be changed from the Quick Set tab. However, if you are up for a more advanced setup, there is the WebFig tab, which is our web graphical interface, or you can even use the terminal through your browser. Now that is the web interface. It might be the most likely place where you start your Mikrotik journey. However, it is not the best tool. But before I dive into what is the ultimate way to access and manage your router's devices from your computer, let's consider another scenario. You just plugged in your new home access point and you only want to make a couple of quick changes. Your computer is in another room, but your cell phone is in your pocket. Lucky for you, there is an app for that. Actually, two. For some very basic features and an easy to understand interface, you have the Mikrotik Home app that is available for Android. But for a complete RouterOS configuration, we have the Mikrotik Pro app, which is available on iOS as well as Android. Alright, but what is the ultimate configuration tool? If you are somebody who will be working with Mikrotik devices regularly, or you just need to access a device that doesn't have a DHCP server running or doesn't have an IP address altogether, then Winbox is your go-to solution. It is a small program for connecting to routers' devices, and while the appearance might be somewhat retro, don't be fooled. It gets updated and improved regularly. It is more responsive and convenient than the web interface. Also, it is more visual, and anything that can be configured in RouterOS can be done so through Winbox. It was designed for Windows, but there are ways you can run it on Mac and Linux. And by the way, the next generation of Winbox will be built using a cross-platform solution, and it will have a more modern appearance. An amazing aspect of this tool is that it offers two additional options for establishing a connection to devices without using IP addressing. Let me show you. Open the Neighbors tab, and there you should see any directly connected devices with their corresponding MAC addresses. Then just click on One to connect. A little side note, while you're using the MAC address to establish the connection, underneath it there is not a true Layer 2 solution at work. Instead, this is using our own protocol called MAC Telnet as a means to exchange the background data necessary for the graphical user interface. That protocol runs above the IP layer using broadcast IP addressing. And the only complication of that is that you will need some sort of IP address on your computer's physical interface. But even a link local address will suffice. And you will be able to connect to a router that does not have an IP. Another connectivity option for Winbox is what we call RoMON. That is another unique Mikrotik solution that truly works over Layer 2. But for security purposes, this functionality has to be manually enabled. What it will allow you to do is to use one of your multiple routers' devices as an agent to manage the other ones. So as long as you can connect to that first device, you can manage and completely reconfigure the rest of your network without accidentally locking yourself out because you changed something on Layer 3. A neat feature for managing remote or hard-to-access setups. All in all, the web interface and the Winbox are your most likely go-to tools to manage your devices from your computer. But besides those, we allow you to use SSH and Telnet if you choose to, or you can completely disable those options for security. RouterOS is a very malleable in this sense. You can build a system that meets your requirements. However, if you ever happen to tighten your security so far that you can no longer access your device, remember that you can always use the console port as a final means of access. At least as long as your specific model has this port and you can still remember your password. Finally, I have to mention connectivity options for tinkerers and businesses. We have two APIs available. There is the REST API that works through simple HTTP requests, and there is a more hardcore API where you open a socket to a router and exchange bytes of information. Some cool projects could be built with those. However, if you are a business with a lot of clients, then maybe you don't need all the options provided by the APIs, and you prefer a more standardized way to manage devices at your client's premises, then the TR069 protocol is going to come in very handy for you. To enable support for this protocol, you simply have to install the TR069 client package that can be found in the download section of our website. I think we covered all the ways that you can connect your Mikrotik device. If you are new to our products, leave a message in the comments and tell us about your experience. Was there any information that would have been helpful to know when you first started? And maybe it would have been nice to just watch a video about it.